So why don't you give us the short version of what's here?
Hi, so I'm Morgan. I'm the head of electrical design of the student organization called GRiP, and our main focus is creating adaptive technology solutions for everyday use. So we actually started around 3D printed prosthetic and task-specific devices for kids with lung differences, and then one of the kids was like, hey, I kind of want to be able to play Smash, like, is there anything to do for that? Which created a game controller where the joystick is now moved to the bottom, so you can play against your leg or any other class, which then expanded to the hands forward controller, so all the buttons are rewired and stuff like that. And now we take personal requests to the controller, so we do the SNES adaptive controller as well. We also do adaptive toys.
You know, yes.
Toy design.
Yep.
And we still do the original 3D printed prosthetics as well. So if you can see here, there's a guitar pickup line that we have, so that you can tap them.
Yep.
Drumstick prosthetics with different levels of shakeability. That's not a music term, but I think the
LED
people know what I mean.
Gotcha.
But and then we also 3D print different stuff. So like this is
that's a switch. Yeah. You'd like that.
Extender, so that you can play with the joystick against your shoulder.
That is a big D-pad.
Yes.
And light. That's a very light D-pad. That's very good.
Light D-pad, also shooting buttons.
Yeah.
We also have a lot of
I like the green.
It's the right green.
I love it.
Okay, yeah, so just a bunch of different stuff that focuses on being able to let people.
And you have kids also working down in the gaming lounge?
Yes, they're at the Microsoft booth as well. We make adaptive devices for the Microsoft controller. Something that was something that I got to think up about.
Yeah, all right.